Trying to make sure I survive. takes a lot of energy, and I'll try my best to get a couple of like closer shots. And I'll call him right now and coordinate that. So I got my car here and I can charge with that. So not too bad. I'm gonna try to charge an external battery that I wasn't able to. Earlier.
Thank you. IFB. This is IFB for your class.
Already.
How dark it is, and all the things in the flash of these lights, and you know, the view that we're able to wear, is Nate.
Yeah, this guy's a bunch of things.
It is
drive to this address, you're going to encounter two roadblocks.
Yeah, kind of looking back up.
At the first one, tell them that your media are like a crew. At the second one, tell them that your media
are
like a crew.
I Yep,
have the north side, which I run.
Done on the source of the D. Done, don't. I'm on that northeast side. That's where apparently the Baltimore's were shuttles. I think at some point one of us could be looking at this.
Hi, Jesse. Certainly, good morning. We are expecting a briefing from first responders and officials here at the base of the Francis Scott Key Bridge at 7, 8, and Eastern Time. That's where we're expecting to get an update at the scale of this devastation. And right now, it's difficult to really just take in just how big this tragedy is because we are still under the cover of night. As the sun rises, we get a much better sense of just how much damage there is and how much work there will be when this recovery begins in earnest. But right now, the number one concern that the first responders on the scene is helping those people that may have been on this bridge when it went down. As you rightly point out, it happened at 1:30 this morning. We do know that there was a group of construction workers that were on the bridge at the time. In fact, my colleague Julia Jester caught up with a group of family members who had stationed near a convenience store near the bridge looking for answers. They were searching and trying to figure out what happened to their loved ones. They had not gotten any communication as to what had happened to them. They basically went to that store just so that they could get as close to the bridge as possible, but have yet to learn anything about the status of their loved ones. As you have also pointed out, the governor, Wes Moore, declaring a state of emergency as it relates to this tragedy. And I think it's also important to point out just what kind of chaos this could potentially cause this region. This is a main artery that's around the city of Baltimore, a mile and a half span that thousands and thousands of cars drive over every single day. As I was driving up from the Washington, D.C. area, you could already see signs posted along the highways warning drivers to stay away from this area to find alternate routes to get around Baltimore as a result of this bridge no longer being passable. And it's also going to be a lengthy recovery, a long time to rebuild this bridge because, as you've shown over and over again, almost the entire bridge appears to collapse after this cargo ship hammers into the base of the ship, or of the bridge, I should say. And so it's going to require a massive rebuilding effort in order to get this bridge back up and running. But again, the number one concern right now is the potential loss of life. The effort to recover the people that may have been on the bridge at the time. And just to give you an idea of what it's like here right now, it is very cold. We are in the high 30s right now, between 35 and 39 degrees. The water temperature is going to be somewhere in the 40-degree range, maybe 45 to 48 degrees. It would be very difficult for someone to survive conditions like that for a period of time. So that's why you saw first responders rush to the scene as quickly as possible. One of the other things we're noticing right now, in addition to the police cars and first responder vehicles that are coming in and out of this area, is that there are a number of helicopters that are circling over the bridge and that area right now, looking down.
That's a lot quicker.
Trying to see whatever they can. But I have to say, it is basically pitch black right now. It is hard to see anything because it is so dark. They certainly have just had to be waiting for the sun to rise in order to be able to see exactly just what they're dealing with right now. But there is, by any measure, this is a serious tragedy and something that's going to take quite a bit of time to recover from.
Yep.
Oh, Galesville. So it was forced that she had to be there. She didn't want to. She had liked her desk, but she had been there for 2 years at that spot. And she didn't want to move, but she was forced.
So here is an example. She probably keeps asking you, and you don't want to move. You should tell them to play
his charms.
Yeah, charming
that I've bridged
it.
Pockets. Because you can't call, just can't.
her go to the music. Yeah, well, two bridges in the water. So I'm not in the water, but yes, I'm where it used to be.
Dig
me up and wear the rings. You've got to be here for the ribbon cutting.
Chopper
pilot, didn't deal with her. They had to rescue the woman who fell off the cliff.
service.
So the sun's coming up over here. Yeah, it's terrible.
That's cool.
Terrible self-service. There's so many areas that I have, like, to this day, Tom, I don't even know how they got my stories in, because we didn't have hotspots. They didn't invest into it to begin with, but it made no sense at all to do so.
Thank you.
genuinely wonder, what went wrong? Because, fortunately, well, see, that's extra crazy to me than how no one got hurt on the ship. How is there a fire? And they've got,
in from CBS. How you doing? Josh, we've met a few times. I got great footage of you, footage of that woman tackling that white supremacist back in Charlottesville. Yeah. I'm going to set up right next to you, man, if that's all right. I'm going to shrink down here. Is that cool with you?
Well, what, you doing the camera?
Yeah. Well, what is your... Are you shooting this way?
I'm shooting this way.
Okay, well, take a step in front of you, yeah?
Yeah, why don't we work?
All right, cool.
Come on, big happy guy.
DC Live.
Yep, so that's the boat that hit the bridge. And the bridge is gone.
Yeah, and we're still recording. Yeah.
There's a beach further down.
Right. It's a little tucked in though. I think this is one of your best vantage points. I'm with the Associated Press.
Oh.
So we share our video internationally.
This
is going out in front of the world. So it's watching you say we're live.
So you guys basically work independently to sell whatever video you make.
We are an international flight. Where's that at? sure that's closed off right now.
There's still search and rescue. I think that's the main thing right now.
Are you zoomed in on the ship?
Yeah, you can see it. I'm all the way zoomed. So you can see where the bridge. Still see some of those search and rescue ships. That's just my focus.
Likewise.
Two. Yeah, my goodness, right?
Thank you.
What role is the FBI playing in the investigation?
FBI has basically to see if there's any terrorism connection, which there's not.
Any confirmed deaths?
No confirmed fatalities.
Any recovered from the water alive?
It's still under, still the rescue mission is still active.
Do you have any sense of what happened to the actual cargo ship? There were some reports that it suffered some major power outages just before it crashed into the bridge.
Too early in the investigation.
Was a pilot operating the ship coming in and out of the port? Was it a port authorized pilot or was it the captain of the ship?
No,
the
pilots move ships in and out of the port.
What's happening?
Pilots move ships in and out of the
port. What's happening to all the other ships that are waiting the backup?
Basically, we're communicating with them. They obviously understand the situation, and we'll deal with the logistics of that later.
Has the crew been evacuated from the ship, and
that's all being done right now. I don't know the exact details of where they all are, but that's obviously
what contacted. Is this being investigated as suspicious?
In any type of incident like this, the FBI would be engaged. Just to make sure, and that's what we do.
And you've got to look at how many vehicles are in the water. Can you just any idea how could this happen? This bridge
too early.
Should not have collapsed like this.
Too early investigation.
Well, could you
how long will the port be closed?
Do you know how deep the water is there in sort of this area where it happened, the conditions?
Approximately 50 feet. 50 feet.
How many people
can you give us an update on how many people were rescued, how many were pulled from the water, how many are still searching for?
That is what we're doing. We're basically searching for everyone that was potentially on the bridge. As you can imagine, it's the middle of the night. You know what type of traffic was there? How many workers were there? Workers, they obviously come to a project, but other workers show up sometimes. So that's what we're investigating right now.
Is this unprecedented? Is there anything like this ever happened?
Not in Baltimore.
Sir, can you talk more about the workers on the bridge, what was going on, and how many vehicles you think might actually be in the water?
There were, they were basically doing some concrete deck repair. We don't have the number of vehicles.
Do we know who they worked for?
I don't have that very offhand.
How long will the port be closed? I
just been looking for 7 people.
A number of people, that's the one number that we've had, but obviously we're researching to see if anyone else was on that bridge.
Can you speak to some of the challenges?
All of the above, to be frank. A very, very tough situation. 1 a.m. in the morning, very little information at the time. Happened instantaneously, as you've seen.
Sir, it's been a number of hours at this point. What can you tell family members who might be watching about any hope that you will still recover survivors?
We actually have set up a facility for any family members. We have health professionals there as well, so there's everything.
And are you ruling out any kind of intentional motive?
We don't see anything that relates to that at this time. It's an open investigation, but there's nothing that points to that in direction.
First calls after the incident come in directly from the ship. When the ship hit there, who were the first ones to make the 911 call?
I don't know. I don't have that information. It's too early.
Just clarification, last question, please. Port is closed except for trucks moving transport out.
Right.
This bridge was built in the 1970s. I'm sorry. This bridge was built in the 1970s. It took about 5 years to construct it, right? Any idea what we can expect moving forward? I mean, the bridge is...
Too early. Obviously, we reached out to a number of engineering companies. So, obviously, we've got a long road for the rest of this day. Okay, thank you so much.
copy someone in a car crash.
Have a good rest of the day.
Take care.
Safe travels.
Who are you working for?
AP. Cool. You know about this spot or you just get lucky?
Well, it's on the other side.
Really?
Took the tunnel twice today.
Okay, so you've been at it for a while.
Yeah, 4 a.m. I got the call.
Wow.
And some folks over there said they saw a dateline in the rear view. Just a little further down.
Yeah, that one is in the pier in the way.
Yeah.
That's the spot. Everybody else is over there.
Way down.
Fort Armistead is there. That'd be a long shot.
Yeah, I think it's closed. From what I've heard.
What's that?
Folks trying to get in and they couldn't.
Oh, yeah.
So, this is about as close as you get.
Well, I mean, it is a park, so it opens at dusk. Or should it open at sunrise?
Yeah, I think it's emergency vehicles parked there.
Oh, okay.
So I think it's, the park's probably closed all day.
That's quite a ways away. But then again, I guess
at least the Armistead Park I'm thinking of is like right next to the bridge.
Oh, that's Fort Armistead.
Fort Armistead.
Yeah,
got
Fort Armistead is closed, yeah. I tried to get in there. That's the first place I went.
Yeah.
Everyone I knew that was going to be blocked off. I mean, that's right under the bridge. That would have been prime real estate.
Yeah, Armistead Park, though, it definitely is pretty out into the bay, but another...
That's Fort Smallwood Park.
Oh, okay.
That's Fort Armistead is that way.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Yeah. All the different shots that come in today.
Uh-huh.
I think the best view is still the aerials.
People over there with drones, but it's a little windy for those little things.
Yeah. Today is good.
media. I'm a video camera operator. I work for, I'm a freelancer. So I do more live events. And I live in the area. Woke up this morning and looked at my phone and went, oh shit.
Got up.
Grabbed my coffee and jumped out, right out the door. I didn't bring the dog.
Yeah. No time today. We got to jump on it.
And even that, it's taking me at least an hour to get here. Trying to figure out where the best spot is. I found another alternative spot that I might have to hike to, but I don't know what it's going to be like. Which is a lot closer.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd say the other side of the bridge.
Well, I would say, there's a spot over here that's just to the other side of Brandon Shores is the wastewater treatment plant there. You just pass that, there's another road that takes you all the way down to the water, but there's another plant there, just kind of walk around.
Yeah, just north of the bridge.
No, this would be south.
Go to